It's Laynie, and welcome to the channel. Today, we're definitely doing things a little bit differently, as you can tell. I'm staying behind the camera, mainly because I've been needing to do this so badly. I really need to swap out some stuff from my makeup bag. If you've seen these videos before, this setup looks a little different. My hubby got me this years ago, and I haven't been using it. I was using a little tiny makeup bag. But finally, I was like, I want to play with more stuff on the regular, and it just doesn't fit in there. If you don't know, my makeup area, my beauty space, hello! My beauty space is in our basement. I don't have a big house, so it's not super far away. Sorry if you can hear water in the background. I am doing dishes. I should say my dishwasher is doing dishes. But anyways, my beauty area here is in our basement. Off the basement family room. My daughter's room is upstairs by our room. She naps and I come down here, sometimes get ready. I really prefer to get ready upstairs, so I'm close by in case she has like a bad dream or has an issue. Like, I'm close by, I can pay attention while she's napping. Yes, I am that mom who still worries when their child sleeps, even though she's two. Okay, I don't think it ever ends, honestly. If you're a mom, let me know. Does it ever end? Like, I still check to make sure she's breathing throughout her nap. But anyways, since I don't get down here to the beauty space often, mainly on the weekends when my hubby's off work, I decided it's time to pull out the big boy. I need more variety in my day-to-day life. I use this when I'm getting ready for work, if I have something going on. It comes in real handy. I have enjoyed the switch. But I'm getting tired of what I have in here. So let's look through. What do I want to switch out? Let's see. Okay, let's go. So these are the three eyeshadow palettes I've been keeping in there. These are so beautiful. Oh my goodness, but they are so sensitive. They break really easily. This one is totally neutral. It's mainly greens and neutrals. So I'm definitely switching these two out. I'm thinking about keeping that one in there just because it's such a pretty topper, like so pretty, but I'm kind of tired of these. So let's start with that since those are my biggest space taker uppers. I have my Juvia's Place, which is very neutral. This one gives me fall vibes. I'm feeling more springy, summery. Ooh, these are pretty. This one is very rainbow. It's not one I reach for a lot. Warm tones, and then of course the Tati Beauty. Oh, this one's pretty. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. This one's pretty too, and I don't use this a lot. Some nice neutrals in there. Of course, the OG Jaclyn Hill. The second one, which I heard this saying that said these aren't eye safe, so I don't know if I should be using it or not. I don't know if that's true. I should probably look into that. This one's kind of calling my name. This one is a little bit, I never use this. So, well, I think these will be the three. That wasn't too hard. Okay. I never pick out my lipsticks and keep them in my travel bag, travel tote, whatever you want to call it, because I usually do whatever feels right on the eyes, and then on my way out the door, I come down and pick out a lip product. I do need to switch out my mascara. There goes the dishwasher again. Mascara, there you are. Okay, so I'm gonna swap my Snapscara for this Maybelline Falsy Surreal. I am gonna pull this out because I've been loving so much more this e.l.f. camo brightener, I guess, corrector. This one bunches up on me terrible. It's just too emollient, so she's going bye-bye. My friend hooked me up with this. I'm so excited to try it out. So So since I have the new one, this one is about gone. I think I will pull out my Revlon. This is just a concealer I use as a cream bronzer. I'm still using my e.l.f. Camo concealer, still using my Thicket Stick It, and the Where'd It Go? The Lift and Snatch pen. These two work so well together. All of my brushes are staying the same. I really need to wash this little puff, but I do really like it. I have been enjoying the Huda Beauty in, I think this is, yep, Cupcake for my under eyes and pore area in the T-zone, but I've been setting the entire face with this Pure Banana Powder. I am debating on if I want to swap her out for this Wet n Wild, but maybe I'll save this until we get a little farther into the warm weather. It honestly has really cooled down here again, so maybe I'll save this for a hotter time of year. I'm still trying to use up this Glowish bronzer powder. I love this. This is in the shade Medium. This goes on beautifully. It's like the perfect tone for bronzing slash contour. I love this, and oh my goodness, it has lasted forever. I am thinking I will swap out these two, the Juvia's Place highlighter and my Fenty Beauty. Oh, I do love this little e.l.f. one so much. Love it, love it. Like, there for a while, that is all I use, so I should probably leave her alone. Maybe I'll grab this Believe Beauty and why not? Artist Couture. As far as primers go, I'm going to keep that one for now. I'm going to keep all of my foundations. I'm kind of trying to use up my drugstore foundations. I have basically most of them in there. And then I have like my more high-end ones. I'm really trying to use up those drugstore ones in like the next couple months so then I can switch over to these. I'm trying. It's a work in progress. I'm trying to find those products that I just can't live without. And I was so tempted to hit up House Labs at the Sephora sale, but I didn't. I was good, okay? Pat myself on the back for that one. Real. So definitely going to keep using the Professional Super Setter. It is the only one I have. I really enjoy this. I'm going to keep this in there. I have been thinking about swapping out my blush. I've kind of been tired of this one. And since I am going with that super, oops, nope, where are my blushes at? There you are. Since I'm going with that super pinky toned palette, maybe I will pull my two pinkest tone blushes and see how that works. You know what? I might be pretty good with those swaps. So again, this one is in the wrong pile. Pulling out those, my Fenty, oh, I probably just broke it. My Fenty Kilowatt Foil, my Juvia's, oh my word. Really? Don't you love my house shoes? You can't tell, I live a glamorous life here. this is the highlighter in, yeah, I don't know, it doesn't say. Oh, volume 3. Alamar Cosmetics in the Fair Light Colorette Blush Trio. I do love this, honestly. Actually, I love all the products I'm pulling out. The only one I don't love, I should say the only two, is this Becca. Used to love this under eye brightener, but it's so emollient as I've gotten a little bit older. It's creasing up pretty bad on me. And this Falscara, I really like it, but it seemed to dry out pretty quickly, and then I started to kind of get some fallout. I love the taupe palette. This worked really well as a bronzer, and I love my little green palette, but I was ready for a change, so change it is. Oh well, what the heck. I'll let you guys see me in all of my... glory. But really, I know this video was simple and sweet, but I hope you enjoyed it because sometimes a simple refresh of my makeup just feels so good. I feel good. I'm excited to put my makeup on today and I feel like I need it because I am not about to go to work looking like this. Facts. All right, guys, that is all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure you click that subscribe button. Join the fam. You won't regret it. I hope you won't regret it. I don't think you'll regret it. And as always, please try to stay positive because at the end of the day, that is truly all we can try to do. Seriously, thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.